Hi, I'm Jane Velez Mitchell, bringing you the very latest breaking news on a story that I've been following for quite a while, a proposal to build a monkey breeding facility in Hendry County, Florida, and import, reportedly, allegedly, 3,200 monkeys from outside the United States into Hendry County, Florida, to breed them for laboratory experiments. Now, a lawsuit has just been filed by the Animal Legal Defense Fund. I want to go straight out to Animal Legal Defense Fund attorney Chris Berry. Chris, you've been involved in the filing of this lawsuit by ALDF, Animal Legal Defense Fund. Who are you representing? Who are the plaintiffs? And what essentially is your lawsuit alleging?
Hi, Jane. Thanks for having me. We filed a lawsuit against Hendry County on behalf of residents who are living nearby the proposed primate facility known as SoFlo Ag or Primera Science Center. And we filed this lawsuit under Florida's Sunshine Law, which generally requires that whenever any sort of important decision-making function occurs, that function occur at a public meeting after public notice so that citizens have an opportunity to voice their opinion and to let their concerns be known. And that simply didn't happen here. Hendry County has approved the development without any sort of public hearing, without providing any public notice, and have entirely cut the people and these residents of the county out of this important decision, which is whether 3,000 monkeys reportedly coming from the wild, these are that can be carriers for a wide range of zoonotic diseases, including some strains of Ebola, herpes B, which is fatal 70% of the time, tuberculosis, parasites, and other diseases are potentially going to be in this neighborhood. And furthermore, there have been documented instances in the past in Florida, actually, where primates have escaped from breeding facilities such as this and have actually bitten and injured people, leading to lawsuits and so forth. So in light of the gravity and of the decision to approve this facility right next to a residential neighborhood, we've filed this Sunshine Law lawsuit in order to force the county to consider this in the public.
Now, Donnie Moss of TheirTurn.net, you reached out to the county. What success have you had talking to county officials and or the company behind this?
Well, I did speak to an executive or an official from Hendry County today, and I asked whether or not construction of this facility had already begun, and she said no. And that actually contradicts what we've seen in local press reports that the facility has already started construction. So that's number one. I also asked if this lawsuit would put the pause button on the construction of this facility, and they wouldn't answer that question. They referred me back to a press release. Jane, it should really come as no surprise that the county kept this secret from the public, because can you imagine the public, well, we now know what the public response is. People are outraged that over 3,000 monkeys, which are known to carry infectious diseases, would be brought into a residential area during a time of a crisis. Monkeys are from Africa, which is the center of the Ebola epidemic.
Guys, you're going to be upset with me, but I want to start this again, because I think what's happening is that the longer we're on, the worse the connection gets. And we have to stop this one time.